the wealth disparity that exists between blacks and whites in the United States at an economic forum on Friday. The Congressional Black Caucus and the Joint Economic Committee unveiled jarring statistics that they say shows what it means to be black in America. Even African Americans with college degrees accrue less wealth than white Americans without college degrees, said Representative Carolyn Maloney. Quoting what she said was the most startling statistic, this absolutely makes no sense whatsoever. And we'll have further details on that as that develops. Unlike the overwhelming majority of American immigrants, most African Americans do not descend from ancestors who chose to live in the United States. Instead, we were forced here during the transatlantic slave trade. More unarmed African Americans have already been killed by police in 2015 than were lynched in any year since the 1920s. The outpouring of grief along Morris Park Avenue shifted to the Ferenga Brothers Funeral Home on Allison Avenue, where the first of the three funerals were held for those killed in the Halloween tragedy. And the 24-year-old man who was killed, his service is tomorrow. And details on the Perez family have not been revealed as of yet. Three men were shot during a Halloween party at the Wagner House this Sunday morning, according to the NYPD. Two of the victims were standing in the third-floor hallway of 350 East 124th Street about 1 a.m. when bullets started flying. Striking both men in the back, police said the third victim was walking up the stairway between the third and fourth floor when he was shot in his right shoulder. All of the wounded were expected to survive their injuries, according to authorities. It's unclear what caused the shooting. The shooting causes grief and concern in the neighborhood because it comes exactly 2 weeks after Detective Randolph Holder was shot to death in the same housing project. And there were roughly 9,000 fewer suspensions in city schools last year than in the previous one, a 17% drop. Department of Education officials said that 44,000 suspensions in 2014 to 2015, and the decline was greater, a 20% dip in suspensions. And today was voting day. I hope everybody went out to vote for your preferred candidate, and the polls will close tonight at 9 p.m. It's 66 degrees. Tonight it's going to go down to the 50s, kind of cool. And this is Bill DeFawcett, WHCR 90.3 News, next report at 9 o'clock. Bulletins are alert at any time.
This is a journey into sound.
We are on the air.
Frequency clear.
Do not attempt to adjust your dial.
Don't touch that dial.
Dial.
Keep it locked on WHCR 90.3 FM.
You need to keep it locked. Keep it locked.
The voice of Harlem.
Turn it up.
Just call my name.
That you could call on when you were in trouble. Ever had a love who comes to you on the double? There's no need to look no further. I'm waiting here for you. Time for you when you worry.
is calling down. Be there in a hurry. All you have to do is snap your fingers and I'll appear.
Nobody in the world, nobody in the world does it like my guest today. Ah, what a way to open the show. The next music you hear will be that of the incomparable, legendary Miss Mary Wilson. Life has been good to me.
All right, all right, all right. Simmer down, simmer down. Now let's bring on our next guest. She's one of the founding members of the legendary group Supremes. She's now on tour on the release, Life's Been Good To Me. So coming to the stage, it's Miss Mary Wilson. Let's give her a round of applause.
Life's been good to me. Even though the sun didn't always shine, it's still been sweet. Life's been all right with me. And I'm thankful for the life I got to live my dreams.
Travel from country to country. Was only trying to make it out the city. And never in my wildest dreams I would make history. I guess you could say this project girl got lucky.
Life's been good to me. Even though the sun didn't always shine, it's still been sweet. All right with me, and I'm thankful for the light.
days.
Life's been good to me. Even though the sun didn't always shine, it's still been sweet. Life's been alright with me. And I'm thankful for the life I got to live my dreams.
Life's
been good to me. The sun didn't always shine, it's still been sweet.
It's still been sweet.
Life been alright with me. And I'm thankful for the life I got to live my dreams. No day is quite the same. Sometimes you will feel pain, but don't let it get you down. Trust it will be better.
Yes, indeed. Life has been good to me. I like that. I like that.
You know, it's positive.
It certainly is, and we need that. Oh, listeners, won't you please welcome to the WHCR studios. Here with Love Notes with Allison Williams in the Chill Zone this evening is Miss Mary Wilson.
Thank you, Allison.
I'm so excited to have you here.
Thank you.
I almost don't know what to say, but
yes, you do, girl.
That never happens.
I know it never happens. And I saw you on stage there. Was it Minton's?
Yes.
You were fabulous.
Thank you very much. That was quite a surprise. Mary and I had a chance to do Diva Simply Singing out in Los Angeles for Sherilee Ralph for the AIDS benefit, and had a really great time. It was just a wonderful lineup of performers. And then when I looked up on Thursday, when I went to go host at the Sugar Bar
here in New York,
here she is across the country. Then they decided they were going to surprise me when I went to go and do my show at Minton's on Sunday.
B. Michaels.
Shout out to B. Michael.
He's so wonderful. He and Mark Anthony.
Yes.
They said, we got a surprise, Allison.
Oh,
and you're going to be her surprise.
And you were. You really were.
You really, really were.
That was cool. Well, so now tell me, this is your new single. Life has been good to me.
Life's been good to me. It's been out for like a little while, but it's still new.
Okay.
And I'm very proud about it because it's all original music. It's from a CD that has yet to be released, but at least they can find that on iTunes and Amazon.
Very good. Very good. We need to know that. We need to know that. Mm-hmm. As I was doing my research, obviously there are many fans and listeners who know the story of you being the founding member, one of the founding members of the group, the Supremes. And I wish I had more time because this bio that I have it's just chock full of so many things. And I like most of all what you went on to do when you left the Supremes. Mary Wilson has been an ambassador for so many causes around the world. You are a motivational speaker. You are a teacher. You are all these things and continue to do your shows. I love the fact that those gowns go on road.
Yes, honey. I let them tour.
Yes.
I let them make me a little money on the side.
Yes, you are a smart businesswoman, and we love that.
Yes.
And it inspires us.
Yes.
You know, you've paved the way for so many artists in and out of the female girl group genre.
Yes.
Do you know what I'm saying? And it's incredible that we have this time to share with you. Is there anything in particular you need everybody to know?
Well, you know, I got the new dance song, dance record out. That's totally new for me.
That's the next thing we're going to play.
But what's really great about my career, and I'm very happy about it, is that we the Supremes, you know, we started 50-some years ago. And, you know, there were a lot of firsts that were started back then.
Yes.
And there were a lot of people that we came on their shoulders, but, you know, hopefully a lot of people have done the same with us. Flo, Diane, and I, you know, we started singing back in 1959. Were you born then, girl?
I was not yet born,
but I was on
the way.
Uh-huh, because you one of them young'uns.
officially changed the name from the Primettes to the Supremes, that was the year I was born.
Okay, all right, 61, And, you know, it's wonderful to have a legacy like that. Because, you know, it's for the Supremes, when we started singing, black wasn't beautiful yet to the other folks.
Exactly.
And I think that's why I have my Angela Davis pin on today. You know, black is beautiful.
It's beautiful. Always has been and always will be.
And we were very, very happy to be one of the artists that helped to move that civil rights thing along.
You broke ground and broke barriers.
Well, we were just, you know, one of the people. There were many others, but we were there and we were glamorous, which I really liked. You know, I remember we were on Ed Sullivan's show like every Sunday, and we were like, hey, we're on Ed Sullivan's show.
Yes.
And it was just a great time, you know, and to be there when like Stevie Wonder started out, Marvin Gaye, the Temptations,
Marvelettes. Everybody come along.
Everybody come along. And let me tell you, Motown was a wonderful company. Mm-hmm. It really, really was. I'm very proud to have been, you know, one of the artists on that label.
It's incredible. Mm-hmm. It is incredible. Well, listen, I know that you came here from a very busy day and a very hectic week, and you're about to go down and see Miss mm-hmm. Cicely Tyson.
And James Earl Jones.
And James Earl Jones.
You know,
game.
One of the first...
I'm so jealous, I want to go.
You know, one of the first acting jobs I had was the Supremes did the Tarzan TV show. We played nuns. And James Earl Jones was one of the actors on that show.
Wow.
This was back, what, 68, 67, something mm-hmm. like that.
Mm-hmm.
It must have been 68. And so now to go see him tonight with Cicely Tyson is such a wonderful
privilege.
It's going
to
privilege.
Be incredible. Yes. I got a chance to see her do Trip to Bountiful.
Yeah,
she was astonishing.
Great? Oh, yeah, I saw
she
her too.
Astonishing. Well,
yes, she's my friend. She's my friend. I'm very happy to say
I'm
that.
I'm so glad to say it as well. Mm-hmm. I met her as a result of my relationship with Dr. Maya Angelou.
Yes.
And,
yes.
And also Sandra DaCosta,
mm-hmm.
who I can remember going to the Cicely Tyson School in New Jersey
mm-hmm.
and teaching
oh, yes.
the kids and mentoring in a program.
Mm-hmm.
And she, you know, she'd come, you know, she likes to take pictures as a hobby.
Mm-hmm.
So she had her camera
oh,
with her lens
okay.
and she was just, you just look and go, this is the same woman that I see dressed mm-hmm. dripping
mm-hmm.
on the red carpet, but
mm-hmm.
she's just ever so
yeah, she's
just
a wonderful
normal
human
down
being.
To earth.
I want to start a school as well to pass on some of the things that we learned as young mm. girls when we were at Motown, because
yeah.
Motown had an artist development school.
Like none other.
Yeah,
like
and
none
so
other.
We were taught how to, you know, sit, perch on stools,
mm-hmm.
and walk, and get
yeah,
in and out
grace,
of limos.
To have grace, and
yeah.
exactly.
Oh, honey,
have
we were
grace,
given
yeah.
all of that.
Yeah,
and
that
it was
charm
so
school.
Nice.
And the woman who ran that.
Mrs. Powell.
Mrs. I had a
Maxine Powell.
Had a chance to meet her when I lived in Detroit.
Oh, did you?
Fabulous.
Great,
yes.
Yeah. Well, she taught us a lot. She mm-hmm. really did. And
she
says to the girls, you're just diamonds in the rough, and we're here to polish you. I'm like, all
oh,
right.
And polish. Polish they did.
Yes,
and
yes.
you're still shining quite brightly.
Yes, yes.
Absolutely. Let's go on to this next tune that I want to make sure we get in before you have to fly off
my
and
dance,
leave us.
My dance
yes,
one.
You got to dance.
And see, they have a lot of different mixes mm-hmm. on there, so we mm-hmm. have to make sure we do the radio mix, because
radio
otherwise
mix,
it's really dance and it gets very long. So
okay. Well, thank God for the fade one.
The first one, okay, okay. Yes, because we don't want to play the disco or the, you know, the house one.
Well, I tell you what, we know that in a moment it's going to be actually time for you to move on, so let's listen to
okay.
time to move on.
Okay, time to move on. It is.
Stand just to show you who I am. been in your shadow far too long. I was losing where I came from. I understood when you had to leave. It's what you said and what you did that took my head out of the clouds to find out. I gotta move on, got to move on, got to move on.
Unfortunately,
I got to move on.
You got to move on. Miss Mary Wilson has been my guest this evening, and I am over the moon. The time went too quick, but we want you to be able to get to the theater.
I still got a little time.
You got a little time. Okay, well.
Because I still have a Supreme gown collection that travels around.
I saw that in the research, and that's incredible.
Right now is at the Grammy Museum in L.A.
Oh, wonderful.
So I'm really proud about that.
Good.
I love the group. They're doing a lot of good work. There and it tours around the world.
Mm-hmm. And you've been touring yourself as well, mm-hmm. doing your tribute to Lena Horne show.
Yes.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, I want to share this with you. When I went to the Sugar Bar to host on Thursday of last week, of course, I had no idea who I'd run into because we had just been on the West Coast kicking up our heels. Or getting turned up, as they say.
And you were fabulous on
that
show.
Thank you. I was still
on the sidelines watching you.
It was great. It was great. It was Mary Wilson.
Eloise Laws there, Frida Payne.
And they did a tribute to fabulous jazz women. And you did Stormy Weather.
Yes, Lita Horne.
Eloise did...
Nina Simone.
Yes, I put a spell on you. And
Frida Payne
Ella. Did Ella. And
she does a great Ella.
Have you seen her show? God.
Oh, yeah.
It's a great
one-woman
show.
Frida and I work together a lot.
Yeah. We can't wait to see your one-woman show. Mm-hmm. And I know that it's coming to New Jersey. We just don't know when.
Yes.
So people have to keep their ear open for Mary Wilson.
Or go to my website, MaryWilson.com. Keep
it
simple.
Absolutely. And we hope that our listeners are streaming in www.whcr.org, and you can actually see us here and Mary and all her fabulousness.
Oh my! This is my Angela Davis.
We got you. You're giving it all of that. You're giving us all of that.
That's my girl. Peace.
And if you
black is beautiful.
And it is. If you want to call in, it's 212-650-6903. Directly to the studio. Coming up next, we have Mr. Nate Lucas of the Nate Lucas All-Stars, featuring Mr. Jeff Redd is going to be with us too. And that's coming up very shortly because we got to get Mary off.
I got to go and see Cicely and James.
Absolutely. Well, if you must. Absolutely. Well, it's been my pleasure to have you here, Mary.
Thank you.
And I can't wait to keep up with all of the great things you're doing. People, you must go to the website. You must go to iTunes and Amazon and pick up the music. Life has been good to me, and time to move on. Mm-hmm. And there's just constantly new things happening with you.
Yeah, you know. You got to do that. You know what I mean? As long as you're here, you got to keep on moving.
That's right. Keep on moving, reinventing yourself, and remaining relevant.
Yes.
And of course you do. Now, you're going to Ohio.
Yes, in fact, the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame Museum is giving a tribute to Smokey Robinson.
Oh, okay.
And I absolutely adore Smokey, as a lot of us
do.
And
the Supremes are part of the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, aren't they?
Yes, we were inducted in the 80s.
Wonderful.
This is going to be a tribute to Smokey Robinson. Mm-hmm. So I'm going to be singing a couple of his songs.
Nice.
And give him a little tribute. And, you know, because he and the Miracles really were the first people who gave us a big break mm-hmm. back in the 60s.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm very happy to be able to do that. So this is on this coming Saturday. And I think, from what I understand, that Sirius, yes, mm-hmm. XM will be running the program.
Oh, wonderful.
Yes.
Good,
I'm sorry,
good.
This is WHCR. So, but anyway. You know, it's
we're
okay.
All
we
on
all
the, band.
The music is all cool. It's
band.
All cool.
You know, and as the voice of Harlem, we have to echo
yes.
into the Harlem community so they know what's going on and where to find you.
Oh yes.
And once again, we're mm-hmm. so glad to have had you, honey.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, my love.
Mm-hmm. Ladies
and
gentlemen,
you were fabulous. Okay, I was
you.
Like, you go, girl.
Thank you so
and
much.
And you, know, but you know, one of my favorite things you did was the fat guy. I'm like, yeah, but you can keep.
Was that Big Fat Daddy?
Big Fat Daddy.
Oh,
you
yeah,
were singing.
We have a good time
I'm like,
with that.
Okay.
Over at Minton's, y'all, you got to show up. You that never was, know who else will.
That was nice.
The first two Sundays of every month. I got a caller before we go. Who is this? Who do we have on the line?
This is Rome Neal.
Hi, Rome Neal. How are you?
Oh, Rome O'Neal.
Rome Neal.
Yeah, poets. Hey.
Absolutely.
New Yorker poets.
That's right. And Banana Pudding Jazz. There mm-hmm. you go.
And Banana Pudding Jazz, yes. So good to hear you ladies on the air and see Mary with you, Allison.
Oh, it's an honor. Trust me, it's an honor.
Hi, honey. How are you doing?
I'm doing quite wonderful. good to have you back. I can feel your vibe. I haven't seen you personally, but I can feel your vibe in New York City, girl.
I know. Well, you know, I did an off-Broadway play with him I lived here. Yes,
oh,
yes.
Oh, wonderful.
Thank you, my darling.
Played by Ishmael Reed.
That's
Mother
right.
Hubbard, that's right.
That's right. Right. Well, nice to talk with you. Thank you for calling in.
My pleasure. Listen, we remember you at the Adelco Awards one night. You
yes.
were a presenter, and
that's
we,
right.
we want to give a shout out to Allison, who's going to be a host of the Adelco Awards this year.
Yes, on November 16th.
Wonderful.
I was about to talk about that a little bit later.
Oh, great! Yes,
mm-hmm. really
I did attend it. It was really mm-hmm. beautiful.
Kenny Seymour and I will be hosting that.
Oh, cool. Okay. All right. Well, thank
okay,
you.
Okay, darling.
Okay.
Have a great
November
time
16th.
At Gin.
Okay.
Gin Game.
Okay.
Good
bye-bye.
To hear from you.
Bye bye.
Talk to you later, Jerome. Isn't that great? I'm glad
That's
someone
wonderful.
Got to.
Yes, he gave me a big break because I've done some off-Broadway things, mm-hmm. and he was. I was in the play with him, and it was really wonderful. Ishmael Reed was.
Wonderful.
Yeah. Okay, well, I guess I'm out of here, right? I got to go.
You got to go Woo-hoo! Because you got to go.
That's my girlfriend,
that's
Gladys.
Mm-hmm. That's my
so
girl.
What we're going to do is we're going to bring up that music. So we can usher in our next guest, and I'm gonna just play this and then let the music tell the story.
Find I searched the end and end.